हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, हाउ आर यू ऑल? वेलकम बैक टू आवर ऑनलाइन क्लासेस फ्रॉम एलपीएम पब्लिक स्कूल सिचुएटेड एट गोला बाजार गोरखपुर. दिस इज योर इंग्लिश टीचर नैन्सी पांडे. सो माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डू द रिमेनिंग एक्सरसाइज of chapter number 4, that is a visit to Shillong from your English reader book. So students, as you know that this story is about of the famous hill town, that is Shillong. In this story, the description of Shillong is given. This story is about of two little girls which are going to spend their holidays with their grandparents to Shillong. So students, in our previous video, we had done the question number A, B and C. I hope you completed question number A, B and C in your fair copy. Now let's do the question number D. Let's play with words. Question number D. Circle the opposite of these words. Now, let's read the first one. Earlier. So, my dear students, the first one is already done. The opposite of earlier is later. So here you have to circle the word later. That is already done for you. Now look at the second one, colorful. So students, do you know the opposite of colorful? The opposite of colorful is dull. So here you have to circle the word dull. Now let's come to the third one, best. So students, you know very well the opposite of best is worst. So here you have to circle the word worst. Now let's come to the fourth one, joy. It means pleasure. So the opposite of joy is sorrow. So here you have to circle the word sorrow. Now let's come to the fifth one, pack. So the opposite word for pack is unpack. So you have to circle the word unpack. Now let's come to the sixth one, shouted. So the opposite word of shouted is whispered. So here you have to circle the word whispered. Now, question number D is completed. Let's do the question number E. Read the clues. Add another word to each of these words and write the new words. Now, students, look at question number E here. few hints are or clues are given, you have to add another word of this word and you have to write the new words. The first one is done for you, parents of grandparents. So, grandparents. So, students, you know very well, parents of your parent are known as grandparents. So, grand is already written. You have to write parents in the given blank. So, when we add grand with parents, it makes a new word, that is grandparents. Similarly, you have to do question, you have to do second, third, fourth and fifth. Now let's do the second one, the ground where we play. So students, the ground where we play is known as playground. So the play word is already given. You have to write ground in the given blank, then the word play and ground make together playground. Now let's come to the third one, water that falls from a height. It means waterfalls. So you have to write falls in the given blank to make a new word, waterfalls. Now look at the question number 4, a shelf where books are kept. So my dear students, you know very well, a shelf where books are kept are known as bookshelf. So here you have to write shelf in the first blank and the word book and shelf make together the new word, bookshelf. Now look at the fifth one, the room where they sleep. So here our answer is bedroom. So you have to write room in the first blank and bedroom in the second blank. Now let's check your spelling test. Question number F, change the first letter to make a new word. So students, here few words are given for you. You have to change the first word and make a new word. Like first one is given, look. So here we change the letter L and write B to make book. Now look at the next one, second, that is ear. So here you have to replace the letter Y with N to make the word near. So you have to write the spelling of near in the given blank. The next one is joy. So the another word for joy is boy. Here B is replaced with the word with the letter J. Now look at the fourth one, pack. So here you can write sack. The next one is this. It is so the another word is fish. You have to write fish in the given blank. The next one is cake. So you have to write bake in the given blank. B is replaced with the letter C. Then it become a new word, that is bake. Now let's read about punctuation. Let's know what are punctuation. We put a full stop at the end of a sentence and we put a question mark at the end if a sentence is a question. So students, in your English grammar book, you studied about sentence. There you know that we put full stop at the end of sentence and we put question mark at the sentence if the sentence is a question. Now let's do the short exercise of this topic. Question number G. Put a question mark or a full stop at the end of each sentence. Now let's do the first one. Where are the sweet falls? So my dear students, this is a question. So here you have to put a question mark after sweet falls, like this. Now look at the second one. Grandma will bake a cake for us. So here you have to put a full stop on the end of the sentence. Now let's come to the fourth one. I love Shillong. Here you have to put full stop on the end of the sentence. Now let's look at the last one. Will you come here again? So here you have to put question mark at the end of this sentence because this is a question. So students, you have to put question marks on the first, third and fifth sentence, and you have to put a full stop on the end of second and fourth sentence. I hope this exercises is clear to all by this video. So you have to do this in your fair copy and you have to do discuss this with your family members like your brother, sister, etc. So students, do your homework regularly and don't forget to learn them. Thank you students. Bye and take care. Till then, stay safe, stay healthy and stay at your home.